I get some absolutely terrific ideas from those of you leaving comments, so thank you all very much for leaving comments. I spend a lot of time reading your comments. I learn a lot from you guys. One of the recommendations that I received from a commenter was that we run the Slick 50 engine, the engine that we unseized previously, run this engine again until total failure. And I thought that was a terrific idea. What we've done is cut open the side of this engine so you can actually look inside the engine as it's running. And not only that, I'm going to run this engine until it locks up or until it throws a connecting rod, whichever comes first. Also, we want to, before we do that though, we want to diagnose the problem. This thing has a really bad engine knock, and I want to figure out why it's knocking so bad. And also, we have this cutaway of this engine, and we're going to use it to sort of show the viewers where the problem is at inside this engine. Anyway, I've been looking forward to this project for quite some time, and this should be a lot of fun. This engine has a really bad knocking sound, so I'm going to go ahead and show you where the knocking sound is coming from. This is the connecting rod, this is the crankshaft, and the sound is coming from where the connecting rod attaches to the crankshaft. And I'm going to rotate the flywheel back and forth. You can actually see the motion where there's a lot of slack in there, and you can hear a lot of knocking. So as you can see, the connecting rod's not moving, and the crankshaft is. There's a lot of play in there. And this is exactly why you don't ever want to run an engine without oil. It just totally runs it. So this noise is coming from right here. Again, this is the crankshaft, and this is the connecting rod. There isn't a bearing that's used on these small engines. And as you can see, this hard steel coming in contact with this aluminum's just not going to last very long if it doesn't have oil. And that's why this engine, next to this setup is basically ruined. The connecting rod cap on the left is normal. The one on the right, as you can see, there's a lot of scoring. And that's, it's a lot of material has worn away from not having lubrication, and that's the source of the knock. This is inside look of the connecting rod where it attaches to the crankshaft. As you can see, there's a lot of scoring on it as well. Okay, I'm gonna put this engine back together, and then we'll run this engine without any oil in it. But what I wanna do first is I'm gonna lubricate the connecting rod with some Lucas heavy duty oil stabilizer to give it the best chance to run as long as possible. So I have a tachometer, I have a clock, and I have a temperature gauge. We're going to measure the inside of the engine temperature as it's running. As you can see, here's the crankshaft. The connecting rod is not attached. Okay, I'm holding part of the engine in my hand. So what I'm gonna do now is go ahead and tear this engine apart and let you see what happened on the inside. The first thing I'm going to do is use a rod, and I'm just going to push on through the engine, and I'm just going to push the piston out of the side of the engine that I'm on. Okay, I'm going to push the piston out. Look at that connecting rod. Just tore that thing right in half. Just destroyed it. Here's the other half right here. We'll piece this thing back together in a minute. Just curious how this thing came apart. Here's the other part of the connecting rod right here. Wow. Just snapped it right in two. There's quite a deep gouge in this piston. There's also a very deep gouge in the cylinder wall. Here's a look at the connecting rod where it disintegrated. These are the pieces. You can see the connecting rod literally broke in half. It literally had parts flying out of the other side of the engine. You can see where the connecting rod came apart and the different parts here. This engine just really exploded. This engine coming apart was a little bit of a surprise. I did not expect the engine to come apart like that. It's a good thing I was in a different room and shielded from all the parts that came flying out the engine. I'm all about safety. With that being said, it was pretty cool to really see firsthand why you never want to drive a vehicle for long that has an engine knock, because at some point the connecting rod is going to come loose, it's going to break apart, and it could potentially throw a piston through the side of an engine, totally running it. It's pretty neat to see the cutaway of this engine too while it was running. I've never seen parts come flying out of an engine like that. That was pretty cool. Anyway, if you enjoyed watching this video, I hope you'll consider giving it a thumbs up, and hope you'll consider subscribing, and look forward to seeing you next time.